In this video, we'll show you how to replace a failed pressure switch. Begin by recovering existing refrigerant from the system, because the capillary tube is often connected to a gauge port, and there may not be a Schrader valve inside. First, remove the cover to reveal the dual pressure switch. Loosen the screws to remove the wires. Then, pull the wires off the switch. Now we can remove the pressure connections to the low and high side pressure ports. When removing these connections, it's best to use two wrenches to avoid torquing the copper pipe. Unscrew the flare nut, winding the capillary tube up and out of the way. On this old switch, the high pressure was set at 450 pounds. And on the low pressure side, our cutout was set at 40 pounds, and the cut-in is set at 60 pounds. So when we install the new pressure switch, we use those same settings. Now it's time to install the new Danfoss KPU pressure switch. You can see the low pressure side on the left and high pressure side on the right. In this instance, the low and high pressure scales are on the same sides as the original pressure switch, but that is not always the case. Be sure of the location of each pressure scale. Here's the Danfoss KPU dual pressure switch. On the low pressure side, pressure goes up to 108 pounds. And on the high pressure side, the pressure goes up to 600 pounds. On the left side is a manual trip lever, labeled Test. By depressing the lever, we don't get much movement in the contacts. That's because the resets on top of the switch are set to manual. And those can be moved backwards. You can see that if we move the manual reset back, we can depress our test lever on the side. The reset in back is connected to the low pressure, and the one to the right is connected to the high pressure. This switch has a convertible reset. It can change from manual to automatic by moving this cam. When moved to this position, both pressures are set for manual reset. In this case, we want the high pressure side set to manual reset to function as a safety switch, and we want the low pressure side to be automatic. So we're running a condensing unit with a pump down cycle, and when it hits low pressure, we want the change to shut off. And once the pressure starts to rise, we want it to cut back in automatically. To do that, rotate the cam clockwise, forcing the manual depressor to stay back. And now it's going to operate in an automatic mode. So now we can move the contact mechanism up and down freely. So our low pressure is automatic and our high pressure is manual. The installation is similar to the way we removed the old switch. Next, you'll see four different screws inside the switch. These are C, B, A, and D on the contact system. Line is installed on A. Load is leaving on C. Contacts B and D may be used for an auxiliary function such as a light or alarm. Attach the ground wire, then fasten the screw. Next, connect the line and load wires at terminal A and terminal C, respectively. Put the front cover back on. At this point, the new switch is wired. Next, we'll connect the low and high pressure capillary tubes. Tighten the fittings with two wrenches to avoid torquing the copper pipe. Next, we'll enclose our electrical box. Anytime we open the refrigerator system, we need to change out the filter dryer. With the filter dryer installed, be sure to conduct a standing nitrogen pressure test. The standing pressure test should not exceed the maximum system pressure as recommended by the equipment manufacturer. Make sure that no drop in pressure occurs. If the system experiences no drop in pressure, then it is free of leaks. Next, pull a vacuum down to 500 microns or below. Then charge the system according to best field practices. Loosen the locking screws. Now we're ready to adjust them. Manufacturers use multiple methods for setting cut-in and cut-out points. For this and any automatic reset Danfoss KPU pressure switch that cuts out on pressure fall, You set the cut-in with the range adjusting screw and the differential with the differential adjusting screw. On the high side of the switch, you set the cutout with the range adjusting screw. The differential on this switch is fixed at 60 PSI. We verified what the old pressure switch was set at, which in this case was 450 pounds. So we adjust the screw so that the setting goes down to 450 pounds. On the low pressure side, the old switch had a cutout of 40 and a cut-in at 60 pounds. For the accuracy of the switch, you want to use manifold gauges to verify settings and proper system operation. With that complete, your Danfoss KPU dual pressure switch is installed.